We've been using Time Warner Cable for approximately 3.5 years.
It reaches people that you wouldn't reach typically in other avenues of advertising.
It gets your face out there. People, they see you out in the streets and or the grocery store line, and they say, oh gosh, I've seen you before. I watch you on Time Warner Cable.
There's a lot of people that would not be in a home if they hadn't watched our show.
Time Warner Cable advertising.
It's all about choice.
Revolutionized sports television. Now is redefining sports radio.
We're the only radio show that has a regular staff psychologist perfectly qualified to discuss sports talk radio.
Fox Sports Radio.
Time Warner Cable. Roadrunner High Speed Online. Crab Radio. And Fox Sports AM 800. Present the High School Football Game of the Week.
Welcome to the High School Football Game of the Week on CNNSI, Time Warner Cable, Channel 31, Digital Cable 106. I'm Mark Heffernan along with Brian. And, you know, tonight we have the Arvin Bears hosting the South High Rebels. South played one of the top teams in the Central Section, and they were ripped by Edison. Arvin lost a very close game to Burroughs.
Yeah, as far as South's concerned, whenever you get beat like that, you want to go back to the basics, work on your ball security and your fundamentals. And Arvin, whenever you lose a close one, you're right there on the edge. You want to keep doing what you're doing and just push through and get that victory tonight.
James Cam is a premier running back for South High. He's played some quarterback, some running back there, and he is kind of bolstered by a big offensive line.
Yeah, and Kane, he pretty much does it all. We've seen him this our third year, going to see him, and he's an exciting back. And, again, following that big line, he should put up some numbers tonight.
Steven Rodriguez leads the attack for Arvin. He is a quarterback, and they also have some huge people up front.
Yeah, and like I said, we've seen him last year, too, and he's a solid quarterback, and he just needs to keep the Arvin Bears in contention.
Now we go downstairs to Brian Schmitz of Roadrunner High Speed Online.
Thanks, Mark and Brian. Well, I hope you all enjoyed tonight's game against South High and Arvin High that you can kind of see behind me. This should be a great game. Tonight, one lucky player will be chosen based on their speed and how it impacts the game. That one player who impacts the game dramatically through their speed will be chosen as the Roadrunner Speedster of the Week. We'll be choosing one player each and every week throughout the rest of the year based on each game that Time Warner carries. At the end of the game, that player will be brought in front of the camera, and they will be awarded this plaque and also this shirt. They also be recognized on the local website that we have at currentrr.com, and their play will be rebroadcast on that website. So with that, I'm going to say good luck to whoever that Roadrunner Speedster of the Week is, and I'm going to throw it back up to the booth for Mark and Brian.
It's the Arvin Bears and the South High Rebels tonight on CNNSI, Time Warner Cable, Channel 31, Digital Cable 106.
You're watching the High School Football Game of the Week on Time Warner Cable.
Seems every day someone promises you a faster way to the internet. But when it comes to delivering serious speed, no one can touch Roadrunner High Speed Online from Time Warner Cable. Instead of high-speed hype, get Roadrunner for a high-speed service that's easy to get, easy to use, and actually delivers high speed.
Get free Roadrunner installation from Time Warner Cable.
Roadrunner High Speed Online. Let's go.
Now is redefining sports radio.
We're the only radio show that has a regular staff psychologist perfectly qualified to discuss sports talk radio.
Fox Sports Radio.
And welcome to the high school football game of the week from Arvin High School as the Bears take on the South High Rebels in game two this year, Brian.
Yes, Mark, we're at game two here in Arvin in Bear Country, and got South High kicking off and to start this festivities tonight.
We thought we would be here last week.
Yeah, we did, but unfortunately due to the tragedy, everything got delayed a week. But
yeah, well, now it's time to have fun.
Yeah, it is. You know, it's time to for these young men to come out and play high school football.
Yeah, I think this will be a very emotional night for all the players and fans. South High kicks off against the Bears. Bears in red jerseys, white pants. South in white and pale blue. And these teams always play a very competitive game.
Yeah, and they're pretty well evenly matched. And as has been stated already, it's going to be a hard-hitting game. It has been the last couple years I've been here with you watching them. And the key, like I said, the key tonight is going to be who can have the least amount of turnovers and execute on offense and defense.
Auburn competes in the South Sequoia League and South in the Southwest Yosemite League. At one time, of course, they were in the same league.
Yeah.
I have quite a rivalry. Edgar Morris making his first start as actually his first year as coach of Arvin, his second game, replaced a longtime coach, Chuck Chamberlain. And Steve Falk, the head coach of South. Arvin with the ball. Nice tackle, number 14 for South High.
And that's Andrew Worthy right there. And that's what you have to do. Run that defensive line. You know, all you want to do is get off the ball and cause disruption in the backfield. And again, on any level, you know, you want to get these teams in second and third and long, so it comes with advantage to the defense, so now you can start doing some different things on your defense with some pressure.
Second and 14 for the Arvin Bears. Quarterback is Steven Rodriguez. He also plays free safety for Arvin. Couple of receivers wide to the right. Defensive back backs off. Ball comes to the tailback, kicking backfield and slam down. Number 44 for tackle. Patrick Davis for South. Last week, they only gave 86 yards on the ground, South, but 245 through the air against a great Edison team.
Yeah, and they face a team that is really reminiscent of a VHS team with speed and a little bit of power. But you can see right now, they are tough against the run. They shoot the gaps like you just seen right there. And now they have them in a good situation, third and 14.
Third and long for Arvin. Play action, Rodriguez rolling to his left, looking downfield. Everybody looks to be covered, a pass, incomplete. Almost picked off by South at the 40-yard line. Fourth down, punt time for Arvin.
And right there, South's defense came out and set the tone. They executed two plays in a row, making tackles in the backfield, and then did an excellent job of covering the receivers downfield on a rollout, and they forced a punt situation, and they're going to get good field position if they can field the punt.
Anthony Jones, the closest man to the ball from South High. Receive man, Manuel Vasquez of South High. Looks like they may block the punt. He gets it off. It is partially deflected. Takes an Arvin roll, though, to about the 47-yard line. So South High will have excellent field position here in the first quarter.
Yeah, and so far right now, Arvin hasn't executed. Four plays, there wasn't good execution on that one. Right there, the punter did a good job of moving to get the ball off on a shaky snap. But now they give the ball over to Kane and the South High Rebels and good field position, and they can put what they've worked on all week long since that devastating game against Edison.
James Citizen Kane. Going on back for South, three receivers wide to left. Actually, James in motion. Sean Tobias in the quarterback, long count, pitch back. The ball is dropped. Running back picks it up. Fumbles it again, and I think the Auburn Bears recover it.
In the backfield.
That was definitely an ugly play.
And it's from the start, you know. You push the ball back, fumble it, you pick up the ball, you try to make something happen out of nothing, you fumble again, and we're going to see it coming up right here. The ball's already picked up, and you can't really see the hit, but it's a good hit right on the ball. Ball's loose. Now Arvin picks the ball up, and they almost like this switch position.
Now Arvin has a nice field position here on their second series at their own 49-yard line. Thanks to the miscue and, of course, the ensuing fumble. First and 10 for the Bears, 10:23 to play here in the first quarter from Arvin High School. Actually, a very nice evening for late September. Rodriguez, pitch back, maybe a halfback pass. Throw downfield to the sidelines. Incomplete! That should have been caught. by Juan Corona. He was wide open. He couldn't believe it.
Oh, and right there, everything was executed perfectly except for the catch. I mean, that's just, you're wide open by yourself. There's no worse feeling than dropping the ball all out by yourself in front of the whole crowd. And that was going to be a big play if he would.